When it comes to Team Fortress 2, there are a million different ways to experience the game graphically. Whether you're playing with high settings, medium settings, low settings, late 90s to early 2000s game settings, or even in stretched 4x3, everyone is still playing the same base game. But, have you ever wondered how people get their games to look the way they do, or wonder what in particular configs and launch options do? You've come to the right place. Let's get started. If you've seen the developer console in TF2, which you can enable in the options and then use to change settings quickly, you'll grasp the idea of configs rather easily. By opening any type of TF2 config with Notepad++ or a similar program, you can easily see a list of commands. Therefore, configs are just lists of console commands that your game client runs on startup, one after the other. Sounds simple enough, right? Due to how easy configs are to install and how convenient they are for settings, there are many different kinds of configs. There are configs like mine, which increase the FOV, disable annoying tutorial pop-ups, and give subtle optimizations. And then there are graphics configs like Comanglia's, which squeeze every possible frame out of the game in order to help lower-end machines run it better. Competitive players also like to use these graphics configs in order to get every frame they can where it matters most. If you're interested in my config, I have a link to it in the description. If you're on a lower-end machine and getting sub-60 frame rates in TF2 at all times, there's a new config that came out recently called Master Config, and I'd recommend that one. Now, what about launch options? Some configs give you a list of launch options to add, and I haven't seen much explanation on what these do. And so, I'm going to explain what the most frequently used launch options are for. First up, Novid, which skips the Valve intro every time you start the game. This helps with load times some. Next up is High. This command tells your processor to run the game in high priority mode. DX level tells your game what version of DirectX to run in. The possible values are 80 for 8.0, 81 for 8.1, 90 for 9.0, 95 for 9.5, and 98 for 9.8. DirectX 8.1 yields the best performance out of all of them, but provides a severely inferior graphical experience. I'd only recommend using it if your computer is extremely low-end. Threads tells your game how many CPU cores to utilize. For example, I have a quad-core processor without hyper-threading, so I would input Threads 4. Full, SW, and No Border tell the game what rendering mode to start in. Full is full screen, SW is start windowed, and No Border is borderless windowed, or full screen. Full gives the best performance out of the three. W and H tell the game what resolution to start in. For example, W1920 and H1080 starts the game in 1080p. NoForce MXL and NoForce M-Speed tell the game to disable mouse acceleration, making your aim more consistent. I also advise turning raw mouse input on in the settings. NoIPX turns off an old network standard not in use anymore, giving an extremely minor boost in performance. NoJoy turns off controller support, saving you a bit of RAM. Now, these next ones I've seen quite a lot recently in How to Fix Pyro's Invisible Flames videos, but nobody seems to know what they do specifically. These commands are Force Vendor ID and Force Device ID. The two trick the game into thinking you have a different graphics card than you currently do. The ones floating around the most, Force Vendor ID 0x10DE and Force Device ID 0x1180, tell the game that you're running an NVIDIA GeForce GTX 680. You can change which device you're spoofing by finding vendor and device IDs online, or in Device Manager. These launch options are useful especially now, as it tricks the game into enabling features that it thinks older and lower end cards won't support. If any of these launch options looked appealing to you, great, go ahead and use them. They're really easy to add, just remember that you put a space in between each one. Configs are also really easy to install. Just make sure they're named appropriately and dropped into the TF/CFG folder in your TF2 install. So, now you know how configs and launch options work. I hope this video helped you out, and also helped you get a substantially better TF2 experience. If you enjoyed this video, feel free to check out some of my others. I play TF2 a lot and have a really fun time with it. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.